Hey, I'm Justin. And I heard you. You reached out. You said, Justin, please, oh, please, tell us about the forest. Well, I heard you. Your wish has come true, and I'm inviting you to join me today as we explore today's landform, or biome, as it is, the forest. I bet you already know something about forests. Here's a pop quiz. Which of these places do you think is a forest? A, B, C, or D? If you said C, that's right. And what's a forest filled with? Yes, trees. And I'm not talking trees. I'm talking trees. Lots and lots and lots of trees. Standing tall, like soldiers, or bent over, or leaning to one side, or broken. But all of these trees make a forest. All forests have trees, but not all forests are the same. There are many different kinds of forests, and they can be found all around the world. This is a temperate forest. These forests can be found in places where it's hot in the summer and cold in the winter. And in autumn, the leaves on the trees change color and, well, what happens next after the leaves change color? They fall. Yes, these trees lose their leaves in the fall and winter, and they come back in the spring and summer. Temperate forests see all four seasons. During the winter, some people like to get all dressed up in their hats and boots and mittens and go outside in the forest, taking in all it has to offer. Some animals go to warmer places for the winter, but others are just fine staying in their forest home. Lots of different animals depend on the forest for food and shelter. Deer, black bears, squirrels, birds all live in the temperate forest. They eat nuts and berries and leaves that they find on bushes, on the ground, and in the trees. Lots of different plants live in the forest too, usually ones that are low to the ground and don't need much sunlight because of all the shady trees up top. You can find moss and ferns and mushrooms. There are plenty of different kinds of mushrooms living in the forest. People depend on forests for wood, for food, and for something else too. Take a deep breath in and out. Forests, all kinds of forests, all of them, help us breathe. Plants, like trees, put oxygen into the air, and people and animals breathe in oxygen. We can't live without it. So you can thank all the forests in the world for keeping us alive. Unlike temperate forests, other forests are in places where it doesn't get cold. In fact, some forests are in places where it's always hot. These types of forests are called rainforests. Why do you think they're called that? Here's a hint. Rainforest. Rain. Yes, these forests get lots and lots of rain. It is hot and wet all year long. You'll find different kinds of animals in a rainforest than in a temperate one. Ooh, look at all those bright colors. Here you'll find monkeys, and parrots, and sloths, and butterflies, and birds, and lizards, and oh, so many different kinds of animals. The plants that you'll find in a rainforest are different too. Look at all those different colors. People live in the rainforest too. For thousands of years, different groups of people have called the rainforest their home. They love and respect their forests. They hunt, fish, build homes, and get other things they need from the materials they find in the forest. You and I get food from rainforest plants too. Nuts, fruits, herbs, and so much more. We get cocoa from pods that look like this. This? This is a banana tree. And those green things on the tree are bananas. Yeah, that's what they look like before they come to your home looking like this. What time is it?
It's showtime!
I can't hear you.
It's
Yeah, it's joke time, baby. Woo! All right, I got a good one. I got a good one for you today, and it's about forests, right? How can you get more information about spiders that live in the rainforest? You go on their website. Website. Web. Okay. Let's travel now from the hot, steamy rainforest to a forest where it's very cold for most of the year. Do you see how these trees look different from the other trees in the other forests that we've seen so far? That's because they're evergreen trees. Forests like this are called coniferous forests. These trees have needles and pine cones. And these trees don't lose their needles like how other trees lose their leaves in the fall. Whew. It gets very cold in these forests. They have very short summers and very long, cold, dry winters. Unlike the near constant rain of a rainforest, all the moisture that comes in a coniferous forest is usually from melting snow. So what sorts of animals can you find here? Grizzly bears, lynx, snowshoe hares, moose, and other animals that have thick fur to help them stay warm. I'm so glad I got to spend this time with you. And now you know so many more interesting things about forests. We've been to forests where it's hot, forests where it's cold, forests where there's snow and rain, and we got to meet all sorts of different plants and animals that depend on their forests for shelter. Well, I guess I'm gonna leave now. But I'll see you next time. And remember to always be clever.